our expectations are completely aligned to what the vision of the government is healthcare for all. And we are looking at the healthy Bharat, as you call it, or the Swasth Bharat, as you call it. And our expectations are pretty clear. I think in terms of access and affordability and quality, those three triangles that we talk about, we would like to see that the government's agenda are truly reflected in the execution and the actions and how they are partnering with the private sector as well. Because as a private sector, be it a delivery or a industry in terms of technology, I think we have to partner with the government and vice versa. The government has to partner with us to reach 1.3 billion people because it's not easy to reach. We have the technology, we have the competency, we have the capability. The government has the intent, the government has the coverage, the government has the influence into do this. So if you combine these three, I would say the access, the affordability, and the quality is our intent to reach out to 1.3 billion people. And that's how I would frame it as my expectation in 2015 with the new government and a new year. We have been hearing about the PPP for a long time. And I think the PPP has got some great models to work on. Infrastructure, especially in the construction, in several aspects of the railways, we can see a lot of PPP has gone in. But unfortunately, the PPP has remained not so much from an actionable standpoint in healthcare. So I would say that my understanding of PPP is that there is a good definition of PPP put up, but I don't believe there is execution that is happening true. And for that to happen, I think there has to be trust and confidence. And I think Shivinder talked out in that earlier in his talk, that it's important that the government understands on what framework the private operators are operating, and the private operators understand what obstacles and opportunities the government has in working. If the understanding and alignment is there, PPPs will work well. And I think we need to understand what government strengths are, and the government needs to understand what our strengths are. And with the understanding of the strength will come confidence and trust. That is missing today. And because that is missing today, that PPP formation is not happening as it should happen. I think more conversation needs to happen. And the more the conversation happens, the less is the mistrust and the more would be the confidence. Today, mistrust is happening in every section of the human population because everyone has a perception. Mistrust comes out of perception. And perception can be only shattered through dialogue and communication. Enough amount of dialogue and communication is not happening. According to me, there has to be a platform, a common area where a patient group, a doctor group, or a people association, a hospital provider group, and a technology group should come in together and ensure that we thrash out some of these perceptions that are there. If there is a diagnostic test that is overcharged there, can we not have a standardized protocol? Why cannot we have a standardized protocol where an X test should be having a range that should be there? Why could it be one at, say, 1 lakh of rupees and the same test maybe at, say, 50,000 rupees? Why will it be? If there is B, then there has to be a justification. For example, a product of medical technology, the same product, look-alike product that looks almost similar, there is a difference of, say, 25, 30, 40%. Why is it so? Because the metal is different, the way it is works is different, the clinical evidence is more, the years of testing is much better, the R&D is much more. That is there, but you have to have a reason behind it. And that's where it can be created through a common platform and communication and dialogue. Because the reasons are not understood, this trust, mistrust and misperception is always there. Personally, according, this is my personal opinion, I believe that we need to leave some decisions to the experts. Now, if you go to a car showroom and you try and understand the car that you're buying, finally, the car salesperson or the car technical person will explain to you why this is superior and why this is it. But then you have to believe him. You will not go to an internet and find out, no, this is... Similar, the same thing. If a patient is coming, the patient needs to have a certain amount of trust and confidence in the doctor, because that person has worked and studied for 10 years or 15 years and have so much of experience to give that product. But absolutely, if the patient is asking a question, the doctor should be able to explain why the doctor is prescribing a high-value product versus a low-value product. He has to be able to say, this is the reason. He cannot say, I like this product or the name is good. That's the reason I'm doing it. It has to be a value added to that product. But having said this, we also need to understand, and this is again a basic question that we need to raise. If a doctor is seeing close to 100 patients in a day in a public hospital setting, and if he starts explaining to every patient that this is the reason I'm prescribing this product, that number will come down to 30. That means every day, 70 more patients will get untreated, because today the ratio of doctors to population is 6 to 10,000. So that is the dilemma. We are actually tied up. So if you see, some of our member companies are the Symbiosis Institute of Management Studies. IIM Bangalore is working very closely with us, and Anjan Bose will be able to elaborate you more. But we are working closely with several of these education institutes to ensure that we can provide some of the aspects of technical education to the healthcare providers. Also, we are looking at tying up with the Skill Development Corporation, NSDC. Dilip Chinoy, I think, is in there in the second session. We're tying up with them to ensure that we can increase the skill set of workers. We are also using NatHealth at the forum to look at how we could progress medical education in the country. And for that to happen, the government has to play a very active role to really opening up a lot of quality education through some of the private aspects. You cannot have education done only in government medical colleges and through the All India Institute of Medical Sciences. And they are the best, which is great, but the capacity is not there. And that's where the private providers need to come in and put in their more efforts through medical education. For that to happen, again, that relationship of the government and the private providers needs to be much better.
About the quality of education?
Quality of education, according to me, is very good in India. If you see the MBBS that gets passed out, they are the best in terms of quality. If that was not the case, the most of the doctors who work in all the hospitals, both in tertiary as well as in secondary, several doctors who work even in the tier 2 and tier 3 cities, the quality of outcome is fantastic. And the reason is not because they have gone abroad and studied. Most of them have passed from here, MBBS or MS. So I wouldn't say the quality is compromised in terms of education here. Quality is pretty stable. One is willingness, and secondly also, let's also understand, a doctor gets into a medical health profession, one is it's a very noble profession. Secondly also, they look at it as a career. It is not, and it is not wrong to think, a doctor by going into a health profession should not be able to make money, or should not be living into a society that is being made by someone else doing business. It's the wrong thing to think about. Question comes is, what are we doing as a nation to really help that happen? If I make a doctor get into an MBBS from there and put them into rural, no infrastructure, no money, no facilities, there is no incentive for that person to really go, except for seeing a lot of disease states that will make that person more experienced and more knowledgeable and educated. And today, I believe most of the doctors today go in a rural setting to work is because they believe emotionally that they have to contribute to the nation, they contribute to the society, and also they know that if they go to the rural area, they will learn a lot, which they will not see sitting in the urban area. And that's for the reason we go. But you're right, that there is it's an entire cycle that we need to really fix. It's not only one area. So medical education, by fixing that 1 crore of rupees that you're talking about, will not be solved, because there are several other aspects of the chain that needs to be resolved. my first thing that I would do is to ensure that we really look at the reimbursement or insurance out of pocket. I think when we are talking about healthcare for all, I think there is a system that needs to be done where a proper insured population would be there. Today, the insured population is very few, and the way it is managed is not so good. I think the processes and the way to manage, as well as the number of people that needs to be insured, come with whatsoever influence, should be my number one. So that's the access bit, that's the affordability bit. Second thing that I would do is I would look at my primary healthcare centers and also look at the secondary and tertiary healthcare centers. My primary health centers is so underutilized. I would revamp my primary health centers in an order to ensure that patients who are suffering from those initial stages of the disease should be first landing into the primary center. I would also create a mechanism of awareness so that patients would go to the primary center rather than coming to a center. Today, if All India Institute of Medical Sciences, which is created for specialized treatment, gets 50% or 40% of patients who are could be treated in a primary center, imagine the amount of productivity that these tertiary hospitals could be able to do. So that's my second one. First is insurance, second is ensuring that the right patients go to primary, secondary and tertiary depending upon the disease state, and accordingly I'll beef it up.
So you'll be addressing 80% of the population.
Almost.
That's great.
And the third thing that I will do is ensure that I have qualified healthcare professionals. Which when I say healthcare profession, not only about doctors, about nurses, about allied healthcare workers, everything biomedical, everything is shortage today. And if we don't get this right, we will never be able to, we'll create an infrastructure, we'll create the insurance and the money, but who will going to treat? As you rightly said, a doctor when will be then swamped with 100 patients in a day, and the chance, it's a human being, it's not a robot. The chances of making errors will be high. The chances of irritation factor will be high, the chances of conflict will be high, and it will not be then Arogya Bharat as we were talking about. So these are the three points I'll do.